Hello ladies and gentlemen, Nick here, and welcome to my review of Doctor Who Series 4 Episode 2, The Fires of Pompeii. The second episode of the fourth series of the Revive series, and Season 30 overall, and the third series of the 10th Doctor. This will also be his final full series, although there are still quite a few stories, both in this series and a couple of specials left to go. So the plot of the Fires of Pompeii, after the Doctor and Donna arrive in what they believe is Rome in 79 AD, there's a nice callback to the Romans, by the way, when the Doctor says, that fire was nothing to do with me. Well, a little bit. And then they discover they're in Pompeii, and they're being followed by, is that Karen Gillan from Guardians of the Galaxy as one of the soothsayers? Yeah, a Nebula from Guardians of the Galaxy. She's following the Doctor and Donna. But yeah, the Doctor and Donna are being followed by Nebula, one of the soothsayers of the city. And eventually they go and report back to the Sisterhood of the Sibylline to report back on them. And it's eventually the Doctor and Donna lose the TARDIS and have to go and see Mr. Carkelius, played by, hang on a second, is that Mr. Curry from the Paddington films, Peter Capaldi? OMG, first Nebula, then Mr. Curry. How strange. Anyway, so they go and see Carkelius, about getting their TARDIS back, more or less. However, he soon has a guest, Lucius Praximus, I think, played by Phil Davis. Hang on a second, he's a taxi driver from Sherlock. Huh. I don't believe one of the odds of that. I keep recognising these guest characters from what they do later on. Not necessarily what they did at the time. But yeah, the Lucius seems to be a prophet, as does Carkelius' daughter Evelina. But yeah, by the way, is she and Quintus, are they twins? Because I always thought she was younger. But by the end of watching the episode this time round, I was wondering, maybe they're twins. They could be twins, for all I know. Quintus is about 16. Evelina could be about 14 at minimum, but I think she's closer to 15 or 16, so she could honestly be a twin. I think Quintus is slightly older, I think. Maybe. I think if Evelina was the older one, at most she would be a year older. But anyway, but she's been promised to the Sisterhood, and she has the gift, where they slap their eyes, where they've got eyes on the back of their hands, and they can just get prophecy together. Quintus, on the other hand, just likes going out, basically. Although his mother, I can't remember her name, but the wife, Carkelius' wife, she kind of looks down on him a little bit, but looks up, is very proud of Evelina. It's all right, throughout the story, the family get more closer to each other as we keep going along. It is just a normal family, basically, after all. However, Lucius is more than what he seems, as he is serving these creatures known as the Pyroviles, and believes them to be his lords, and he's been collecting pieces of marble from different marble makers in the city, including Carkelius, to create this sort of energy converter for the Pyroviles. At the same time, Donna is trying to warn everybody about Pompeii, which the Doctor doesn't want her to do because it's a fixed point in time. I think this might be the first time a fixed point in time has actually been directly said in Doctor Who. Of course, we've had you can't change history, not one line, from the Aztecs and stories like that. You can't really change history that much. But this is the start of the fixed point in time stuff, I think, that would get played quite a lot of in for Waters of Mars, and then later in the Moffat era, fixed points, where things should not be changed in any way, or should have very little change. And the Doctor is pretty much kind of wanting to get out of there before they do anything, until he starts seeing the marble stuff, and then sticks around because of the aliens inside, despite Donna's protests. But he and Donna eventually make their way, after a quick visit to the Sisterhood, where Donna's about to be sacrificed, and the Doctor saves her and shamefaces them, even though they don't care. But they do get an audience with the High Priestess and learn about the Pyroviles. They then learn that the Pyroviles are going to change history by not erupting Vesuvius and having Pompeii have a glorious future, and then the Pyroviles take over the planet and make it new Pyrovilia after their planet was lost. Another planet missing, like Adipose 3. How odd. And then eventually the Doctor has to decide whether it's Pompeii or the world, whether to sacrifice Pompeii as part of history or let history be changed and the Pyroviles take over Earth. He has to make the final call, and that is actually a really great moment with the Doctor and Donna having to make the call whether it should be Pompeii or the world. And eventually they decide Pompeii and set off the volcano and eventually have to get back to the TARDIS. And these are two of the best moments of the episode. The Doctor and Donna making the decision for Pompeii instead of the world. And then when Donna has to convince the Doctor to save someone, not the whole town or city rather, just someone. She begs him to save someone, so he decides to go back for Carcelius and his family. And in a pretty heroic moment as well. Yeah, he needs convincing by Donna, but eventually when he does go back to rescue Carcelius, that is another heroic Doctor moment, akin to that of regeneration stories like Plans of the Spiders, The Case of Androzani, and The Parting of the Ways. Bad Wolf Parting of the Ways, but specifically Parting of the Ways. And it's also a moment that later on in the Doctor's life is going to be important for him. He chooses, his successor's successor will choose a face that will remind him to remain to the mark, remain being a Doctor. Never cruel or cowardly, never give up, never give in. The Doctor saving Carcelius will ultimately remind him to be a Doctor later down the line when he enters his 12th incarnation. Well, I say 12th, technically 14th, the 12th Doctor. Also, fun fact, Russell T. Davis actually had a plan to connect Carcelius with John Frobisher from Torchwood Children of Earth, also played by Peter Capaldi. And Russell had a plan to connect the two, but that never went through, that never saw fruition. And then Stephen Moffat kind of took elements of that idea with Carcelius giving the 12th Doctor seeing his new face, and he knew he'd seen it before. And then about a series and a half later, he then remembers and he knows why he's got that face. It's so that he can save people. I'm the Doctor and I save people. In a great moment in that episode, The Girl Who Died. I'll get onto that bit in a while. That's series 9. We've got four and a half series until then. But yeah, it's a nice callback to here. And it was pretty cool to have the idea of Russell trying to connect Carcelius with Frobisher. John Frobisher, not Frobisher the talking penguin, the big talking bird. But yeah, that didn't go through. So Stephen Moffat instead took the idea of Carcelius inspiring the 12th Doctor's getting a new face, as he saved an innocent man, basically. So that's a really good idea. And ultimately the story kind of ends with the family surviving and going off to Rome and worshipping the Doctor and Donna as their gods. This won't be the last time such people honour the 10th Doctor and Donna as their saviours in this series. Another alien race will go on to do that by the end of the next episode. Anyway, so Fires of Pompeii. This is a really greatly written story and some really great execution. The plot keeps going at a fast pace. The fixed point in time stuff. The supporting characters are fun and enjoyable. And the execution is pretty cool. And the monster designs are great. And some great visual effects. I have read that there was criticism towards some of the dialogue by some supporting characters like Carcelius and Lucius being a bit generic and typical. And there are a few of those. It does sound a bit generic and typical to me in places. And I also think the family should have a bit of some of them getting close together before the volcano eruption, so we know that this family does care for each other before they put into mortal danger and then later witnessing the destruction of their city. It would have been great to show, as part of the fact that they are a normal family, that they still love each other no matter what. There are hints towards that throughout the episode, but I think we could have had one scene before the volcano eruption just to show the family actually close, so you'd actually want them even more to survive. So you want them to survive even more, as well as show them to be more of a normal family. But that might be due to the fact that this episode is only 45 minutes, roughly 45 to 47 minutes. Well, on the Wikipedia page it says 50, which is not quite true. It's about 45 to 47. Partners in Crime was 47-48. Speak of dialogue, there's a couple of characters. I think, who wrote this? Was this James Hawes or something? I'm not sure. I think the same guy who wrote the adventure game TARDIS, the only one of the five adventure games not to be written by Phil Ford. Oh, James Moran, that was it, I think. Well, the writer definitely did a great job with the story and the setting. However, some dialogue from some characters, like that market stall guy earlier on, it's a bit modern. There's quite a bit of modern talk in this episode. That market seller guy is definitely a Del Boy-esque character. Del Boy from Only Fools and Horses. Lovely javelin. It's a bit odd. But still, it's a really good and really entertaining episode and a really great highlight of Series 4. However, I do prefer Partners in Crime and also the next episode, Plans for the Ude, for it. But I think this one is still a really good episode early on this in the series and a great entertainment ride and also a great moral dilemma for the characters. Some things in history are fixed, but sometimes you've got to make them happen. Otherwise, history might change and not for the better. So I'm going to give The Fires of Pompeii a 9 out of 10. Yeah, I thought this was a good story and really well done. And they managed to succeed in bringing Pompeii to Upper Boat Studios where they filmed. They did a fantastic job in the sets and the locations. Some absolutely great stuff. I think they did go and film on maybe some location stuff in Rome, maybe a little bit, but not an awful lot. But they certainly did a great job in bringing Pompeii to Cardiff to film. Well, South Wales, at least. Upper Boat was a bit further into, was a bit out of the city, I think, whilst Port Tiger is in Cardiff Bay, more or less. Or not far from Cardiff Bay, anyway. Oh, quick encoder for this review before I wrap up. Peter Capaldi and Karen Gillan would, of course, go on to play other roles in Doctor Who. Peter Capaldi would, as I mentioned earlier, would go on to play the 12th Doctor. Whilst Gillan would go on to play Amelia Amy Pond, who will be the companion of the 11th Doctor. And we will be seeing her not too long away, next series, in fact. Once we're done with the David Tennant reviews, we'll be on to the Matt Smith era. And we'll be seeing her almost straight away, a couple minutes in. So we'll see you again in the 11th hour, Karen Gillan. And technically the next appearance of Peter Capaldi will be Torchwood Children of Earth. But we'll be doing those reviews later down the line, so... the next Doctor Who appearance of Peter Capaldi will be in The Day of the Doctor with a quick cameo. The next appearance will be in The Time of the Doctor and then we'll go from there. Okay, so back to me to wrap up this review. Fires of Pompeii, that was a really great episode and absolutely amazing. But things get more serious and dramatic next time and a bit more personal too, where the Doctor and Donna arrive on the Ood Spear and soon they witness the truth about the Ood. I'll see you guys tomorrow for Planet of the Ood. Goodbye. Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the official Nicholas Payne Retro YouTube channel. Go. Me. Karen Gillan does a great... And speaking of which, I'll get back to actually. Played by... Is that Malcolm Tucker? And then, well, they don't care for some reason. Well, they don't care. And then... akin to that of Planet of the Spiders and the Caves of Androzani. Akin to that of the as another group of anyway, so but it is still quite fun to hear and enjoyable. And I think maybe some stuff could have been maybe the family could have been a bit more maybe there could have been a bit of the I think maybe these episodes could have been extended. So yeah. Anyway. Ultimately, this is a good, fun, enjoyable story. However, some dialogue from some characters, not necessarily... History is fixed. But anyway, but next time things get even more dramatic and a bit more, as the Doctor and Donna arrive on the Ood Sphere, aka the Planet of the Ood, where they... Next time, Planet of the Ood, and I'll see you guys next time. And Peter Capaldi, we'll see you again. We'll technically Torture of Children of Earth will be the next chronological, and technically chronological.